Hey everyone, this is the next video in our series about Pivotal Cloud Foundry. Here in this video, we're going to talk about the auto scaling of the application that we have deployed in our PCF environment. Previous video was about scaling, what is it and why do we need it. If you want to know the details, you can visit the previous video. So let's go ahead and see what we are going to cover. We are going to see the scaling, horizontal scaling, and how to do the vertical scaling. And this is the reference doc that I'm going to take help from for our demo, right? So let's go ahead and get started with the demo. So this is the place where I have, if you are watching the previous videos, so I'm using the manifest YAML to push the application, right? So let me show you the manifest YAML also. This is the manifest YAML file where name is mentioned, and this is the name of the jar, and this is the memory that I'm going to give here, and this is the number of instances. Only one instance I want to keep for now, right? So this is the detail. So after this, I just have to write the command cf push. As we are in the same directory where manifest YAML is there, so it is going to read the information from the manifest YAML and derive the information from there and push the application to PCF environment. So just enter it and it will do all the things for us, right? So I'm just going to wait for the application to up, right? So all the things, details that are coming in the logs, I already have explained to you. So the app is running now. We can see it by the name this, so I can go ahead and access this. So let's go ahead and try this. So this is the route that they have given us. Let me go to the Chrome, okay, and write it here, scaling, and we have endpoint hello, right? Hello PCF. And one more endpoint I have added to this application, IP address, where it is giving the information which machine it is running on. So the source code for that is like this. This is the one liner. This is the IP address endpoint, and this is the init address, get local host, and then from there get host address. So from the machine where it is running, it takes the IP address for that and prints that one, right? So this is the simple code. So I have done this with the purpose, so I will explain, you will see it in a while. So now time to scale this app, right? So if I go to dashboard here and see CF app scaling app, so if I fetch the information of this application, it will give me the number of instances that is running as of now and the memory that it has taken. So scaling started this, and number of instances is 1 and memory usage is 1. So if you remember the previous video, there are both two terms, horizontal and vertical scaling. So first of all, we are going to perform the horizontal scaling. In horizontal scaling, what will happen, we are going to increase the instance of this one, right? This way, right? So what is the command for that? CF scale. First of all, this CF scale is the base command. Then after it, we have to pass some parameter. But what are those parameter? How to get the detail of this command? If you want to get the information about this, CF help, and then write the command that is available with the CF, and it will give you the information about that. So what it does, changes or view the instances count, disk space limit, and memory limit for an app. So this is the usage information that you can give it. These are the options that we have, F, I, K, and M, right? So with the I am going to increase the number of instances. With the M, it is going to increase the memory limit that app requires, and K is the disk limit that it is going to increase. This is about the vertical scaling. So first we are talking to about the horizontal scaling. So I'm going to increase the number of instances, CF scale, then app name, which app I want to instance. So scaling app, this is the name of the app. What I want to do, I want to increase the number of instances. As of now we have one instance, so I want to do two instances. So it is going to increase the number of instances to 2, right? So go ahead and see this. it is scaling the app. Yeah, in just a fraction of second it did the things for us, like right CF app. What I have to do, get the information of this scaling app. Okay, get the information. Now we will be able to see the two instances of the same app running. So in health and status of scaling app, see this thing changed. Now we have two instances running, right? This way. How to see, how to check that we have two instances running? You know, that is why I have printed the IP address. So see the, notice the change in the IP address, right? Same URL we are hitting, but we are getting the different IP addresses too. 200, then 195, right? When refreshing it again too. So we have same app running with two instances, right? Here we have seen how we can increase the number of instances without going down, without stopping the application, right? So yeah, here the demo was about increasing the number of instances. What if we, I want to reduce the number of instances? Suppose I want to take it again to one. So just I have to update the number of instances and enter the same command, right? So it will stop the one instance and it get the one app running, right? If I, it has done for me. So if I go to go and see the information about app scaling app, this is the command. Only one instance will be running, right? See, only one instance is here. So it's time now we move to vertical scaling. How we can do that? Again, see the help command. Remember what was that? CF scale help. So we have used this option I, and it's time we use M and K, right? So M is going to increase the memory limit and K is going to increase the disk limit. The difference between memory and K disk limit is, so M is going to increase the instances memory required per instance, and disk is going to increase the memory for the app where it is running, right? So let's go ahead and use both the things one by one, right? So CF scale, name of the app scaling app hyphen K. I'm going to increase the disk limit, right? As of now it is taking the 1 GB. I want to increase that to 1.5 GB, right? So go ahead and enter this. So it is saying that the entry that I have given is invalid, so modify that. So from 1 GB I want to update it to 1200 MB. So see how it is taking that. So it should be correct, right? This will cause the app to restart. Are you sure you want to scale up? So remember when we were talking about the vertical scaling, we were saying that when we are increasing the resources or moving the app from one app, one machine to another machine which has high capacity, it requires the downtime. That is why, that is, this is the same thing here also. It is saying that the application will go down for some time, right? So if I press yes, it is going to increase the disk limit, but it will stop the app, then restart the app again, right? So it is stopping the app, then it will start. So it is going to take some time also in scaling, right? So 0 of 1 instance is running. So we have only one instance, so it is going to increase the disk limit for that, right? Okay, so app is started and it is showing the health. So app is running and now disk limit is 1.2 GB, the same thing that we did here, right? And what we can do to reduce it, so I just can do the 1000 and it will go to the earlier limit that it has, right? So this way we can change the disk limit. So let's go ahead and change the memory limit by using the hyphen M. Now we have 700 MB. Suppose I want to make it 1000 MB. So this way we can do this, right? So this is the easiest way. So this will also cause this app to stop, because we are changing the memory limit, or kind of we are changing the VM. PCF is going to increase the resources for the same application, right? It is going to buy the new VM for the app, and it is going to move the app from the older to newer one, right? So if I press yes, it is going to stop the app, then start the app for us. So in the meantime, it is going down. It is the main disadvantage with the vertical scaling. That is why in current world, in the modern time world, most of the time every company is going for the horizontal scaling, right? But the main thing, the thing with horizontal scaling is you need to change the code also and handle the how your data is distributed over other stuffs, right? So design changes involves with that. Right. So you can see now the memory limit is changed to the 1000 M. If I want to reduce it, I can do the same thing with this also by doing 700 and all. So one thing also needs to be remembered. So memory, your application needs some minimum memory to running, right? So if I give it 500 M or 400 M, our application won't be started. This is the same as you need local machine, right? So minimum is required, right? By default it allocates 1 GB. I can customize that 700 800 M, and this is the enough memory to start the application, that because our application is very small and it is not doing the very big things, right? So we have covered horizontal vertical scaling, the CLI command. Now let's move ahead and see how we can configure this to be run automatically from the PCF dashboard, right? So let's move to dashboard. This is the scaling app dashboard that we have, right? You can see the option scale or enable auto scaling. So first let's see what is this scale. If I click on this, it is asking me to change the things. I can change the number of instances from here. At the same time, I can change the memory here. I can change the disk limit here. So disk limit, instances, these are the static changes that I can do and apply the changes, and it will be applied automatically, right? So but this I have done from CFCLI already, and I can do it directly from here. This is the option that I have, right? So I'm not going to perform this. Basically interested in enable auto scaling. So if I click on this, it has enabled automatically, right? So then we have option to manage this auto scaling. If I click on this, there is some configuration that I can do, right? So this is the currently in use 2 maximum 3, right? So these are the 2 instances available, right? Scaling rules, scheduling limits, and event history. So if I edit this, I can add the rule here. So if I add rule here, I can see the different options to add the rules, if whether it is CPU utilization, HTTP throughput, RabbitMQ, HTTP latency, container memory, on what parameter I want to scale my application. If I want it based on the CPU utilization, if scale down, there is option for scaling down and scaling up, right? So scale down if usage is less than 70%, scale up if usage is more than 80%, so reduce it to 60. So this is as per the your requirement that you have. If I save it, right, so this rule will be added, right? So when your CPU utilization will go up more than 80%, it will add new instance, right? And the CPU utilization go more than less than 60%, it will phase out that instance and reduce the number of instances, right? But all the time we have 2 instances minimum and max 3 instances. I can change this configuration 5 and I can have this 1, right? So I can this apply changes, right? So this will be honored automatically, right? So the changes gets reflected in quickly, right? In within fraction of seconds, right? So this way you can perform the auto scaling also, right? So this is the auto scaler CLI that you can download and play around with more, right? So this is the thing that automatically that you can do, right? So this is the auto scaling, and previously we saw static scaling where we are manually increasing the number of instances, disk limit and all those stuffs, right? So you play around with this. Want to see other videos, you can see the, you can watch the playlist, and you can watch the this green leather GitHub page also, all the information at both places, right? Here we have source code, right? So I'll see you in the next video with another topic about PCF, right? Take care, bye bye.